Hi everyone, Unboxingalism here and welcome back to my channel. In this short video I will show you how you can connect your brand new Apple Watch with your iPhone and restore it from a backup. The first thing you need to do is press and hold the side button until you see this logo. Then you need to wait until this pairing animation shows up. Next is to open your Watch app and tap on the Start Pairing button. You have two options, setup for myself or setup for a family member. If you have a child who doesn't have an iPhone, you can select this option to manage your family member's Apple Watch. In this video I will focus on the setup myself only. As you can see, the Apple Watch started this pairing animation and I need to hold my iPhone over the watch to scan this animation until the pairing process starts. On the next screen, the Restore from Backup or Setup as New Apple Watch buttons can be selected. This step is the most important one. You need to select the Restore from Backup here. On the next screen, you should see your backups. I will select this one, then select Continue. I will fast forward this loading part. On the next screen you need to accept the terms and conditions. I suggest you read it at least once. It is important to mention that during the pairing process, put the phone close to the watch. On the next screen you need to decide whether you want to share your analytics to improve the product or not. Consider it and select either option. This is an information message about the shared settings. On the next screen, you can set the text size and enable the bold text. Your phone and watch will show the changes automatically. Find your ideal settings and continue. Don't worry, later you can change them whenever you want. On the next screen you can add a passcode. It is an optional setting, but I highly recommend you add the passcode to protect your data. I will add a 4-digit passcode, but you can add a longer passcode as well. As I told you, if you change your mind, these settings can be modified later. On the next screen you can enable the automatic update. To be honest, I like to update my device manually. So in this case I will select the install updates manually, but I highly suggest you to always use the latest software. If you have a Nike watch like me, you can download the Nike app here. On the next screen you can add your Apple Pay settings. In my country I need to give a call to my bank to enable it, and because it contains sensitive information I won't set it up now. But select the continue button and fill out all the necessary information. As this message says, you can make an emergency call if you press and hold the side button. Keep this information in mind. On the next screen you can set the app view. I always use the grid view, so I will select this one. Now the syncing process has started. Please don't move your phone and don't switch off the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connection. On the watch you can see the syncing progress. Don't worry, this process will take quite some time. The setup process is done and here is the welcome screen. I think the backup process was easy and straightforward. It's really similar to the normal setup process. This was a video showcasing how to pair your brand new Apple Watch with an iPhone from a backup. I have made many tips and tricks videos on the brand new Apple Watch. If you would like to get the maximum out of your watch, check the links in the description below. I hope this short video helped you out and you learned something useful. If you did, please consider giving me a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel. That would be really appreciated and would help my channel grow. Thank you and see you in the next one.